Ville, the Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
All right, 19 minutes after 11 o'clock. Thank you for tuning in. We were just talking about traditions, cultural traditions, right? Some of them sounded pretty wacky, right?
Yes.
I think one of the things that we do in our country, and it's not a rite of passage, but it's a weird thing. Nobody will ever tell you how much money they make.
No.
Right? They will never tell you.
No.
Right? I know these artists, right? And they do illustration work. And then they're telling you how they did it. They're telling you how they got the job and everything. But they never tell you, hey, good morning. They will never tell you how much they made.
Exactly.
Yeah, oh, I did really well.
Yeah.
What does that mean? What is really well? How do you know?
Exactly.
Gunny Scarfo is on the phone. He's the co-founder of Nonfiction Research and the co-author of a financial study that tells the secret financial lives of Americans. Oh, good. We finally get to know. And the future of financial services. Gunny Scarfo, good morning, sir. It's an honor to have you on our show.
Good morning, Larry and Robin. Thanks for having me.
You're welcome. Where are you?
From New York City.
All right. And how much do you make?
Larry, I have to tell you, it was raining here this morning.
Was
it? I was playing a little bit of Robin and the Giant for my daughter.
Oh, good.
The puddle song.
Oh, good.
And?
I love that one.
Did she skip the loo?
Yeah, it was pretty successful, I'd say.
You didn't jump over any cows just to make it into manhood, did you?
I was saying to Robin, I thought that revealing the secret financial lives of Americans would be the edgy content on the show this morning. I wasn't expecting naked men jumping over cows.
I found it interesting that they said castrated cows, because I thought that was a contradiction in terms.
That's right.
Well, thank you for coming on. Thank you for mentioning Robin and the Giant, by the way. It's a nice thing to know. So how much do you make? Can I ask?
Well, that's the funny thing. When we dug into this study, we began the study a few years ago, and we really wanted to know two things from the outset. One, what's going on secretly in people's financial lives that maybe they're not talking about in public? And you're right, how much they make is one of those things. And then second, once you know what's really going on in people's financial lives, how could the financial industry actually serve everyday people a little bit better?
And in what way? How would that change things?
Well, what we saw was that Americans are, in staggering numbers, essentially living double lives when it comes to money. So while on social media, Americans are publicly enjoying barbecues and shopping and travel and glasses of rosé, behind closed doors, their private financial lives tell a little bit more checkered story.
Oh, really?
But the numbers were really staggering and a little bit heartbreaking.
Really?
We learned that 52% of Americans have broken down into tears over not having enough money. 52%.
Hmm.
That 37% of Americans have gone to sleep hungry because of not having enough money. And we heard from Americans talking about getting caught pickpocketing for the first time or sneaking toilet paper from their office to save money at home. It was almost as if Americans were like superheroes in reverse, right? They were like invincible in public, but then in secret, they had this other private life where they were really struggling.
Yeah. So, and why is that? Are we not making enough? Are we not saving enough or just being smart enough with our money?
We think it's a number of things. So there are obviously some just personal behavioral things that go on. We think that the financial industry could do a little bit better in helping people get there. But maybe one of the most interesting things that we saw was the influence of social media. So there's a lot of evidence out there that people are experiencing status anxiety from social media. You see everyone else in their best moments, in their best life, and that distorts your expectations of what you think your lifestyle should look like, and it influences you to spend in ways that maybe you shouldn't.
So do you think they're pushing family to the background then? They're so wrapped up in making money that they're just, you know, trying to get all the advancements they can at their job, and if they're not satisfied, they get a better job, and family suffers.
Well, that's one of the things that we looked into. It's a perfect question, Robin. We asked people, what do you tell your friends about your financial life, like your closest friends, and then what do you keep private? And what we saw was that all the things that your friends can see, like where you live, what you drive, where you vacation, what sort of things you buy, people are pushing their spending towards those sorts of things. But it's coming at the cost of other things that people can't see, like how much money is in your savings account, how much do you have for retirement, what is your credit card debt?
Yeah, the future. It's hard sometimes to imagine the future when you're trying to live in the current. And I hear what you're saying about trying to keep up with the Joneses. I think that is a phenomenon that we all are guilty of. And it's pretty easy to pull yourself away from it, I guess. Do you know one thing I remember when I was a younger man? when you have children who are wanting like brand name things, and you know you could get those same shoes for like $100 cheaper.
Yes.
That kind of thing. You know, that, some little things like that make a big difference.
It's a huge difference. And it's played out across the country. It's starting to look in ways that are not great for people. I mean, we've seen that almost twice as many Americans have credit cards as have retirement accounts. And credit card debt has hit an all-time high, over $1 trillion in January of 2018.
You know, can I tell you a quick story? I'm from New York originally, so I knew...
Oh, you are?
Yeah, two brothers that were friends of mine. One brother worked in Manhattan. I grew up on Long Island, so one brother worked in Manhattan at a law firm, and the other brother was a custodian at a school on Long Island. Fast forward 40 years, guess which one has the most money? The custodian, because he was smart. Isn't that amazing?
I mean, that's exactly it.
Yeah.
That's exactly it. I think one of the things that could help more people end up like the custodian would be if they're able to get a little bit better help from the financial services industry. Because, you know, it's partly our fault as consumers, as spenders. We have to be responsible. But there's also an onus on the financial industry to help people get there. And I think one of the things that we saw was that some of the very, very basic things that people need help with and are even willing to pay for help with just aren't easily commonly available from the financial industry.
Are we going to see a renaissance in the savings account? Is that going to make a comeback? Are the banking people going to make it more, I guess, enticing? What's a good word, Robin? Inviting to actually put your money in a savings account?
It's possible. It's certainly one of the things that we looked at. And the other thing that we found that we thought would be really strong for most Americans is, like, when it comes to medicine and our health, we have a primary care physician, right? That person's job is to see the whole picture of your health, to help you set goals, to do wellness checkups, and then they refer you to specialists if and when you need the help. But where is that in the financial industry? Wouldn't it be nice if we all had a personal CFO who could sort of guide us in that way financially?
Wow. So is that something that's happening?
Well, it's only in very small ways. And what we saw was that about a third of Americans would enjoy that and would be willing to pay for it. But right now there's just not enough availability of that sort of service or some other services that will just sort of help people get by and increase their household income a little bit.
When you did your research and did your interviews of the individuals and the financial institutions, were they leery to speak to you about it?
No, everyone was pretty open. Robin, I have to say it's a humbling experience to do this kind of research. I mean, people are really opening up about private financial moments that in a lot of cases they've never spoken to anyone about before. And then here they speak to us at Nonfiction Research. It's humbling and we take it really seriously. The on the other side of like the financial institutions, they were very willing to speak to us, but the thing that we heard from a lot of folks is that when we took them the list of eight things that we had determined that everyday Americans would like to pay the financial industry for, a lot of them just said, that's not my job. I'm a bank. That's not what I do. And we think that there's really an opportunity for those companies to make profit by serving everyday people a little bit better.
I was speaking to a young man the other day, and he has his act together, but his wife was in the hospital, and now he's got this $125,000 bill that hangs over them. And he was asking me if I knew any any services that might be able to help them with that. And I could tell them, I don't know if you know Clark Howard. Do you know Clark Howard, the talk show guy?
I do.
Yeah, so he had some good information on his website, so I directed him to that. But other than that, I didn't know what to tell him. Would the CFO that you're talking about be able to help with something like that?
Absolutely. And Clark Howard is actually a pretty good example of the kind of person who's giving holistic financial advice to folks, Clark Howard is someone that people look to for those sorts of issues.
Yeah.
It sure would be nice if your local bank offered you a Clark Howard advisor.
Oh my gosh.
Be that personal CFO for you and help you make the right decisions, especially in tough situations where, as you described, you have a huge medical bill.
Absolutely. So is that, you just helped me understand more clearly what you're trying to say. So is that what's being proposed? Is that we have a Clark Howard Jr. Over at my bank?
Mm-hmm.
That's right. Yeah, it seems like from the study that we did, Americans need it, they want it, and they're willing to pay for it. We'd love to see the financial industry step in and actually profit by delivering it.
Wow.
You know, in a way, a lady at my bank, I'll call her my banker, kind of helped give me some advice one time. I went in there and she kind of talked to me a little bit about my circumstances. And I was just up front, showed her all my numbers and everything, and she gave me some advice. And that was maybe 6 years ago or so. And she was dead on. And as long as I stuck to the advice, things started getting better. So, and 6 years later, I can tell you they are a lot better.
Yeah, you're a living example. This kind of help can really make a difference in our lives.
So what do we do? I mean, how do we get into this a little further? Can we read the study somewhere or just go to our banks? What should we do?
You can. The study is available on our website. It's free. And our website is thisisnonfiction.com. If you go to that website, you'll see a link about the secret financial lives. And all you do is fill out a form and you'll get the report for free.
Wow.
Well, Gunny, thank you for being on there. That was very informative and did a good job explaining it to us in a short period of time. And thank you for referencing Robin and the Giant. And thank you for laughing at the cow jumping story.
All easy to do. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you.
It was a pleasure.
All right. The website, thisisnonfiction.com. We will take a break. Be right back.
Started in 1975, it's Yendall's Building Materials. Whether you're making repairs, adding a room, or building a house, Yendall's constantly delivers excellent service and top quality materials and many of the tools and hardware you need to get the job done. At Yendall's, they take pride in supplying their customers with